Hello, and welcome to the Church of Fuck You. I'm St. Patrick. Yeah, Church, I know it's been a while, and you know, for that I apologize, but you know what? I'm back. Now, let me just say this. This world has gone fucking retarded. Now, let me understand this. Let me get this straight. So, if a six-year-old little boy wants to wear, say, makeup, he wants to put on a dress, he wants to wear high heels, he wants to have a purse, he wants to play with dolls, he wants to walk around and consider himself a girl. That's acceptable. That's fine. Everyone cheers that. Everyone applauds that. You go, boy. You go. But if a little boy, say, wants to pretend to be a soldier and, you know, shoot things with his little Nerf gun, and or he likes to play, you know, tackle football with his friends, or, you know, let's say he, you know, he pretends like he's Hulk Hogan and he leg drops his pillow, then all of a sudden that little boy has mental issues. You know, he has toxic behavior. Like, seriously, that's the little boy who has mental issues? That's the little boy who has toxic behavior? That's the little boy we all need to be concerned about? Now, I'm not saying we need to be concerned about the first little kid, but it's weird to me how the second little kid is the one that is exhibiting, you know, questionable behavior. Apparently, and I must have missed a memo, there has been a movement to stop getting men or stop getting boys to act like men and to act like boys. Apparently, that is wrong. That there's a problem with that. Apparently, there's something called, you know, toxic masculinity, where you just being a normal guy is wrong. It's toxic. There's a problem. You need to change it. Now, again, I'm not talking about creepy-ass people. I'm not talking about stalkers or rapists or people who just do really crazy, wild shit. No, those people need to be checked, and I completely understand that. I agree with that. But we're just talking about normal, basic shit. Normal, basic things that men do. Say, like, you know, they see a nice female walking by. They might walk up to that female, you know, ask them in a nice little suave way, excuse me, ma'am, you know, I just want to know, can I get your phone number? Maybe we can go out for coffee sometime. You know, just a normal conversation. Nothing crazy, nothing sinister. But apparently that is exhibiting toxic behavior. That's toxic because we talked to a female or because we looked at a female. We found a female attractive. Really, that's toxic. Okay, so let me understand this. Let me get this straight. So women go out here and they spend 3 to 4 hours a day painting their face with a whole rack of shit. They squeeze their fat ass into the tightest piece of clothing they can find. They spend half their check on fake hair and, you know, fake eyelashes and getting their fake nails done. They spend money on liposuction, Botox, tummy tucks, breast implants, and ass implants for the sole purpose of having men not look at them and not talk to them. So that's, you really want me to believe that? That's the shit that you're trying to peddle now. That women go through all this stuff so men, to not get attention from men. Get the fuck out of here. I don't believe it. Not for a second. Now, let me also understand one real fast thing. Because again, we're at a place where everything that's normal or would be considered normal is now toxic. So simply tapping a girl on the shoulder to get her attention is considered toxic behavior. Because, oh, I'm sorry, no. That's not even toxic behavior. That's fucking sexual assault. I'm sorry, if you pat a girl on the back saying good job, not in a creepy, you know, stalkerish porn kind of way, but just like, hey, you know, good job, pat, pat. You know what I'm saying? Now you're a serial rapist. Because again, you're exhibiting your toxic masculinity and she feels uncomfortable and she can't say anything to you because you're a man. I'm sorry, what? The last 20 years, all I've been hearing is that women are empowered. Women are strong. Here, I'm a woman. Hear me roar. Women can do anything a man can do. Women are just as good as men. And women are just this ultimate awesome creature. But apparently, if you tap this awesome, powered, you know, strong Superman creature on the shoulder, she's in therapy for 6 fucking months and on suicide watch. Apparently, we have a different definition of what is considered to be strong and empowered and all this other hoopla that you like to throw out there. See, when I was coming up, if you happen to approach a lady, she wasn't interested, she'll kindly tell you, I'm not interested, you going about your business. If you happen to touch a lady, you know, tap her on her shoulder, whatever, she didn't find it comfortable or she, you know, kind of threw her off, she'll gladly tell you, do not touch me or please don't touch me or, again, where I'm from, don't put your fucking hands on me or don't fucking touch me. You know, they were more direct. To me, that's being empowered, right? being able to stand up for yourself and say, you know, you're doing something that makes me feel uncomfortable, I'm going to tell you. No, that's not the definition of empowered anymore. Empowered is to, you know, just cry about it for 6 months, wait 4.5 years till a person, you know, is on a TV show or does it, whatever, and then all of a sudden now, you know, you're empowered to come out and tell your story of how he touched you on the shoulder. Get the fuck out of here. And the way we justify attacking these men is, you know, well, that's just toxic masculinity. And now we have talking heads on TV sprouting it 24/7. We have articles being written left and right about this shit. And now we have commercials on TV talking about how toxic masculinity is and how men need to check men. First of all, let me just say this from the bottom of my heart. Fuck you and your, you know, definition of what a man should and shouldn't do. Okay. I don't understand it for 1 second. Is that now we're criminalizing or we're making it bad that men are acting like men? What the fuck else are they supposed to act like? I don't get it. So apparently only men that are acceptable now in this new society with these new people. And again, I'm not talking about everybody, but there's a nice contingent of people out here who feel like men should just never deal with women ever, or you know that makes them less than a man. I don't understand the logic in that, but okay, that's okay. But again, you can't tell men how to be men. You can't tell men they're wrong for being who they are. If a man is celebrated for, you know, putting on a wig and putting on a dress and wearing high heels and strutting down the street and acting like a girl and thinking he's a girl, if that is like, oh my gosh, he is so empowered because he's being himself, shouldn't a man who wears camouflage, a Budweiser hat and, you know, walking around with his rifle and a buck that he just shot from 100 yards away, shouldn't he be celebrated as well because he's a man? Or is there only one type of man now that is acceptable in this society? To me, it's all bullshit. Again, I understand the creepy stuff. If you're creepy, if you're stalkerish, if you're a rapist, if you're too handsy, if you're whatever, then yes, chill the fuck out. Somebody needs to put you in your place. I understand that. But don't paint every man into this box or put every man into this picture that we're all like that. Because again, normal shit and creepy shit should able to be separated. And we should be able to talk about the creepy stuff while leaving the normal human stuff alone. And I'm sorry, if you have a problem with men because they're men and you feel like any, you know, any expression of, you know, aggression or anger or just anything that could be considered manly is a problem, and you feel like men being men is toxic, and you are so offended by toxic masculinity, I'll tell you what you do. You tie your hair up, get on your knees, and you can suck my toxic masculinity until your face turns blue. Get the fuck out of here. Men are going to be men. We should not have to apologize for being men. All right, man, that's it. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. This is St. Patrick. I'm out.